Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to, well, not Demiurge Studios, but Mass Effect. This will be my playthrough, blind playthrough of Mass Effect. Couple things while the awesome music of exploration and wonder plays in the background. Three different things, actually. No spoilers, please, to any of the story elements, characters, character development, anything like that. I am playing this blind. I will ban you. I don't want to, but I will ban you in order to prevent you from spoiling any further, whether on purpose or accidentally. I think I'm going to put a little note, title card or something like that to show up in the beginning of the series and in the description. So it's going to be plastered all over the place. Of course, I'm not going to have it written on the bottom of the screen for the entire playthrough. It's an idea, but it'd be pretty annoying. So, yeah. Ignorance is no excuse. No spoilers. Gameplay elements, if you want to say that, that would be fine. That would be completely fine. Yeah, like, you know, you should take this skill or this perk, or, you know, maybe you'd be better off using a pistol in this circumstance. That's fine. That's not spoilerish. To say, you might want to use a shotgun when the ultra baddie invades the planet of Alderaan and so-and-so dies. Yeah, you're gone. So anyway, yeah, I just want to make it no hints, nothing, no cryptic words, because I, you know, I'm a pretty smart person. I might figure it out anyway. And even if I don't, I'll be like, did they just give away something? And I'll be guessing something completely different. Don't do it, please. Just enjoy along with me. Comments, you know, I mean, if you're watching this later on, just see what I'm up to. In several months, I'll be done with this game and I'll be on to number two. I do intend playing the entire series and all of the DLCs. I have the first two games and the DLCs. I've actually had the first one for years. I don't know why. I think I chose to begin Skyrim instead of Mass Effect and got stuck in that, and that was a long playthrough, and then I didn't want to start up anything else for about a year after I finished Skyrim. I was like, okay, let's play some short games, but now I'm back. So I'm rambling now. Two more things. I'm not too good at first-person shooters, so I'm gonna try it on normal difficulty. We'll see how it goes. I am gonna use assists and all that stuff, so bear with me. I don't know if you can change it in mid-playthrough to, you know, easy, but I'm gonna try to, you know, have a little bit of a challenge, I guess. For me, anyway. Last thing, this game is blind. I do know some of the gameplay elements. I know the classes. I know, you know, the backgrounds and all this stuff. I've also played up to right before, well, when we get to the beacon and we're wondering what the hell the beacon is, I stopped there. So I don't know what the beacon is, and I don't know anything that happens after that. And this was a couple years ago, actually. I played that part just to, you know, get myself familiarized with the combat, so I'm like unfamiliar now, but I know the events leading up to the beacon. That's what I'm trying to say, and that's it. I'm, you know, seeing some of the characters that appear after that. I don't really know much about them. I know I've seen the blue-skinned alien girl, and I think that's it. Everyone seems to talk about her, but yeah, I don't know anything about her as a character, just the image, and people are fans of her, and, you know, this, that. And I know some of the voice actors. I know, yeah, Mark Meer does Commander Shepard, and he actually appeared on someone's channel, and, damn, what's her name? I know the name. I know her, this person who does the female Shepard, and, yeah, I can't. I know the name. It's like on the tip of my tongue. So if you say it, you'll be like, I know. But anyway. Love the theme, by the way, that was playing, that is still playing. The wonder, the mystery, a forlorn yet hopeful sound to it. I love it. Anyway, options, just some people I want to see. Settings. Okay, for the graphics. I had to equip this with the launcher. It wouldn't come down and include this. It's like it stopped here or something. Oh, I think here. Yeah, everything's as far up as it can go. High, ultra high, anisotropic. I mean, this is like an 07, I think this came out, so you don't have all the options. And I don't know about film grain. Give me an idea. You know, do you guys like the film grain or no? Oh, by the way, I have a mod installed called MEUITM. Mass Effect Improved. No. Mass Effect Updated / Improved Textures Mod, I believe it stands for. So you can find that on the Mass Effect Nexus. I have a link to it in the description as well. At least for the first video. And yeah, it improves a lot of the textures, obviously, and shadows, and they, you know, include some tweaks like that. So it's supposed to also improve the film grain, so it doesn't look quite so grainy, so you can make things out, supposedly. So let me know if you guys want film grain. Film grain. And the other thing is motion blur. People seem to be iffy about motion blur. Let me know, you guys, if you like the motion blur. We're gonna have it on. We'll see. We're gonna have film grain off. We'll see. So let me know what you guys think. I'm willing to accommodate and experiment. That kind of thing. The sound, I have this down at 50, so you can hear me over stuff. Hardware audio, I don't know if I should have this. It seems to be working okay like this, so we'll keep it like this for now. Seems to be working for me. Gameplay, yeah, combat, normal. Target assist, high, active. Subtitles, yes. Autosave, yes. And tutorials up there on. And this is the entire screen. I guess it deserves its own screen. Controls, I skipped. Right, so I've changed these from the WASD keys. And I don't know what to do about squad. I don't know what to make the squad right now. Maybe there's something on screen I can click on rather than use a key to move my squad forward, rally, that kind of thing. Vehicle orders. Yeah, orders. I have these to up arrow, down arrow too. This might cause a problem. You know what? Move. I'm gonna have rally is fall back, right? Attack. Insert the attack and delete hold position. We'll try that and see how it goes. Start new career.
Welcome to Alliance Military Database.
Thank you.
Classified information requested.
Right, connect. I gotta start my timer here.
Establishing secure connection.
So I don't accidentally.
Secure connection confirmed.
Record for 2 hours straight. New. Not John Shepard. Custom female.
Please log in to access your profile.
Not gonna get into details with this, but naming her Brittany after my first daughter, who I miss very much and I'm trying to get back in contact with. That's pretty much a personal message to her. She probably won't see this, but I'll point it out to her. So anyway, yeah. Love you. Miss you. We will speak very soon. Brittany Shepard. Has a nice ring to it.
Warning, data corruption detected.
Oh.
Please reconstruct profile. Confirm pre-service history.
Right. So, this is your background. You got a choice of three backgrounds. The spacer is both of your parents were in the Alliance military. Your childhood was spent on ships and stations as they transferred from posting to posting, never staying in one location for more than a few years. Following in your parents' footsteps, you enlisted at the age of 18. Colonist, you were born and raised on Mindoar, a small border colony in the Attican Traverse. When you were 16, slavers raided Mindoar, slaughtering your family and friends. You were saved by a passing Alliance patrol and were enlisted with the military a few years later. Earthborn, you were an orphan raised on the streets of the great megatropolises covering Earth. You escaped the life of petty crime and underworld gangs by enlisting with the Alliance military when you turned 18. I like the idea of growing up in space and going from ships and stations and pretty much being a nomad, kind of. Living a nomadic lifestyle, you know, as your parents were... Is it both your parents? Yeah, both your parents were... Go from, deployed out to different areas, so...
Confirm psychological space. Profile.
Now, this is Soul Survivor. During your status of mission you were on went horribly wrong. Trapped in an extreme survival situation, you had to overcome physical torments and psychological stresses that would have broken most people. You survived while all those around you fell, and now you are alone, or you alone are left to tell the tale. War Hero. Early in your military career, you find yourself facing an overwhelming enemy force. You risked your own life to save your fellow soldiers and defeat the enemy despite the impossible odds. Your bravery and heroism have earned you medals and recognition from the Alliance fleet. And Ruthless. Throughout your military career, you have held fast to one basic rule. Get the job done. You've been called cold, calculating, and brutal. Your reputation for ruthless efficiency makes your fellow soldiers wary of you. But when failure is not an option, the military always goes to you first. Hold on a second. Ooh. Hope I'm not coming down with a cold, my God. Oof. Anyway, yeah, I like the idea of the war hero. I started out with a tragic background, kind of even worse than this, though, with Skyrim. So let me just, I grew up in space, on stations and spaceships, starships, and I basically showed that I was a badass with, saving fellow soldiers and defeating the enemy.
Confirm military specialization.
Now I'm not going to read all these. Oh, if you want to pause, you can read about soldiers, pretty much basic. Engineer. Adept. Infiltrator. Sentinel. And Vanguard. I'm actually going to choose Vanguard. A lot of deliberation. I do like the biotics component. I don't know how to use it. I don't think my little playthrough a few years ago, I don't think I had Vanguard. Sorry guys, my throat is all messed up. So Infiltrator I was kind of interested in, sniper rifles and stuff like that, but I don't think you really... I'm looking at it from a stealth viewpoint, and it's not going to be helpful at all dealing with bosses. You're going to have to take them down with a pistol, because all you have are pistols or sniper rifles. I've looked into the classes quite a bit, so I don't think that's spoilery. I think I'm still playing blind. I like this. It's a good mixture. You can have medium armor, you have biotics and weapons together. So, especially deadly at short range. And you have this lift ability where you can lift and throw your enemy, that kind of thing. So I'm going to choose Vanguard.
Confirm facial identification.
Okay, now here's... Keep in mind this is not going to look like my daughter, Brittany. This is, she's not going to have the color hair. She doesn't have the color hair that I'm going to, put on this character. It's more of a nod. So we're here. So this... It looks freaky when you go like this. It looks like her face is, like, gonna implode or something. Kind of torn between, well, facial structure here. Let's go for this. Make the skin a little paler. This is freaky. You really only have this, this, and this. I guess freckles without freckles. Is there really a difference in the anything else? She looks better. Now that I made her paler, she looks better with the freckles. I'm not interested in any scars. War hero, sure, she gets scars elsewhere. Alright, neck thickness. We'll give her a slender neck, why not? Face size. Let's just keep it like that. Cheek width, cheek gaunt, ear size. Yeah, we're gonna keep these the same. I did mess around with this quite a bit. I don't like that nose, it's bothering me. So, what was I on? Head, eyes. Eye shape, I like this one. That's okay. Just really, like, that's intense. These are weird. Yeah. So I like this one. And this one. I'll go with this one. The eye height, maybe bring down a little. I'm gonna keep these the same brow depth. Yeah. Brow height. Alright, bring them down a little. As far as the iris color, purplish violet eyes. Cause why the hell not? Jaw, chin height, same. The jaw, yeah, I'm gonna keep this all the same. The jaw, I'm just gonna make a little... A more slender jaw. Why the hell not? Mouth shape, okay. I think I only like two of these two. That's freaky. Eh. Freaky. So I like this one. No. She looks like she's holding her mouth a certain way. So, I don't know. I like this one too. And that one. I think I'm going to keep that the same then. Mouth depth. Width. Lip size. I guess like that. I don't even know if I changed it any. Alright. Stop messing around here. What do you think? I can't move her around to see. Oh, I can. I'll have to use the other mouse to do. Well, her cheekbone looks crazy like that against the... Yeah, what the hell? I like the way her eyes follow when you do it, too. Not all games, their eyes follow. Okay, the nose. Oh, yes, fix this. Fix... Nope. Just like that. Nose height, depth, we'll keep the same. Okay, so we're right in the middle here. No. Eh. Too perky. No. That's even worse than the first one. You're here, I think, right? Kidding me, I don't like any of them. I don't like the noses. I don't... It's too bony. Too thin. Yeah, it's like... Her nostrils are elongated. I don't like these noses at all. The nose. I can't stop her from moving all over the place. Come on, just up a little. Not that way. Hey. You heard me. Really would like more options. We're stuck with this character for 3 freaking games. By the way, yes, I am looking forward to playing Andromeda. Oh, and also, by the way, nothing to do with what's going on. So if you guys glom onto this, I'm not going to be going to... I know that the basic dynamic with the Paragon and Renegade thing, I'm not going for either one, like, you know, it's just locking myself into a certain answer. I'm just going to answer the way I normally would. So, I know you get special abilities if you're, like, get above certain amount of points in each, and... I don't know. When we get close, I might fudge some answers if we're really close. I don't even know if you can see, you know, on the screen what your Paragon ability is. You should be able to. Well, I guess this one. Because we've got this. And we've got that's really skinny. What about the nose depth? No. It's just, I don't like... Wait. How is that? Does that look alright? That's the same as this, only it's just... The nostrils are flared out a little more. I don't know. I don't know if it makes a difference. I just don't like the nose. No matter what I do, I don't like the nose. So. But, yeah. Hopefully I'll be able to look past it. I'll get past all this, baby. You know. The hair color, I'm just going to make completely really red like that. And the hair... Don't give you a lot of options, because basically your career... career military. But this is the most... fast and loose, the longest one you got that isn't pulled back anyway. Brows are all the way this way. They're really uneven, aren't they? That's like too late. It's pretty natural, isn't it? It's the other one's in shadow because of this light source, wherever the hell it's coming from. I guess from here? I don't know. And now I can't stop... Well, this is a good view, actually, of the brows. It's just too thin. Why does it always look like this one is higher than the other? See that? Freaky. No. No bushy. Oh my god. Oh, I'm going insane. Wait. No. I don't like that penciled in like thin as hell, either. Look how far that is above her frickin' eye. No, you can't... Actually, one of the facial thing, you can bring the brow down, but that would bring both down. This is important stuff, guys. I'm sorry. Just have to... Bear with me. Kind of bushy. Natural, right? Well, we're going to change the color anyway. To not be so freaking dark. That's crazy. That's crazy. Oh, wait. Oh my god, look at that. Look at her eye. Looks like she got... Someone just took, like, glue and put it on. This, like, complete redhead eyebrows. Not too crazy, like that. Just a little. So. I'm so picky with this stuff. I can't make her. Wait. Her mouth looks too big for her nose. Doesn't it? Size. So picky. I don't want her mouth to be out of proportion with her. Can I make the mouth smaller than this? I can make the lips less fuller, but I can't make the mouth itself smaller. Screw it. Okay. Makeup. Hair and makeup. Hair's done. Blush color. More blush than that. Look at that. And this is dark. Dark, darker. I don't want that red. Yeah, we'll go like that. No. It's Goth Shepherd. Oh, no. So we got that and that. What's the difference? This is a little lighter, isn't it? Tiny bit? Yeah. Excuse me. She got all this dark, this red hair and red stuff going on. I don't want to add more red. I don't like the lips, and that's only going to draw attention to the lips. Screw it! Just keep it like this. Eyeshadow color. I like that. I like the smoky eye. Smoky look. No. 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 That's similar. Oh, no. Is that what her... What? That's like half makeup. That's weird. So we got that. We got that, which is even more, right? Oh, this is like... Yeah. We'll go here. We'll go this. Eh. No matter what you do, she still basically looks like Shepard, more or less. I think she's pretty like this. Yeah. So yeah, I'm already hoping that in Andromeda you can customize the face even more, because I just want to make the lips, like, shorter. Not shorter. Less wide. And I can't. I can't do it. Unless I choose a different mouth shape. And I don't like the other mouth shape. I like one of the other mouth shapes. This. What do you think? Is it this one? You know what? Yeah. Yeah. I am a robot. Okay. Okay, so we're going to finalize. You're going to hear the voices, believe it or not, of Lance Henriksen and Keith David in the coming scene.
Profile reconstruction complete.
You'll be unable to change any settings, and yes, I will be bringing this character forward through into Mass Effect 2 and 3.
Identification confirmed.
Alright, so these are the settings I showed you guys before. Same deal. Accept. I love both Keith David and Lance Henriksen.
Well, what about Shepard? She's a spacer, lived aboard starships most of her life.
Uh-huh.
Military service runs in the family. Both her parents were in the Navy.
Backstory, I see.
She proved herself during the Blitz. Held off enemy forces on the ground until reinforcements arrived.
She's the only reason Elysium is still standing.
We can't question her courage.
Absolutely not.
Humanity needs a hero. And Shepard's the best we've got.
That's right, baby.
I'll make the call.
Make that call. Now we gotta read this fast, because it comes... In the year 2148, explorers on Mars discovered the remains of an ancient spacefaring civilization. In the decades that followed, these mysterious artifacts revealed startling new technologies, enabling travel to the further stars. The basis for this incredible technology was a force that controlled the very fabric of space and time. They called it the greatest discovery in human history. The civilizations of the galaxy call it... Mass Effect. Can't believe I pulled that off.
Arcturus Prime relays in range. Initiating transmission sequence.
Commander.
We are connected. Calculating transit mass and destination. The relay is hot. Acquiring approach vector. All stations secure for transit.
One side. There she is.
Board is green. Approach run has begun.
I did the best I could with that, guys. I love this.